congregation please rise?
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Father Robert Weaver. I'm a priest here in the area, the Catholic family of parishes in Norfolk County, including St. Mary's Church here in Simcoe. And I'd like to express my deepest respects and my prayerful condolences for all of you here, the family and loved ones of Mrs. Maria Bicek. So, of course, we are here to pay honor to her incredible life and to pray for her eternal salvation. My brothers and sisters, we have come together to renew our trust in Christ.
Can you stand in front of the mic? We're going to be sending this all over the world.
My brothers and sisters, we have come together to renew our trust in Christ, who by dying on the cross has freed us from eternal death. And by rising, he has opened for us the gates of heaven. So let us pray for our sister Maria, that she may share in Christ's victory. And let us pray also for ourselves, that the Lord may grant us the gift of his loving consolation. Let us pray. O God, Almighty Father, our faith professes that your Son died and rose again. Mercifully grant that through this mystery, your servant Maria, who has fallen asleep in Christ, may rejoice to rise again through him, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated. First reading is from a reading from the book of Ecclesiastes. For everything there is a season, and a time for every matter under heaven, a time to be born, and a time to die, a time to plant, and a time to pluck up what is planted, a time to kill, and a time to heal, a time to break down, and a time to build up. A time to weep, and a time to laugh. A time to mourn, and a time to dance. A time to throw away stones, and a time to gather stones together. A time to embrace, and a time to refrain from embracing. A time to seek, and a time to lose, a time to keep, and a time to throw away, a time to tear, and a time to sow, a time to keep silence, and a time to speak, a time to love, and a time to hate, a time for war, and a time for peace. What gain have the workers from their toil? I have seen the business that God has given to everyone to be busy with. He has made everything suitable for its time. The word of the Lord. And the response is to the psalm is, "The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want." So when I raise my hand, I invite you to say with me. We'll try it together. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. Fresh and green are the pastures where he gives me repose. Near restful waters he leads me to revive my drooping spirit. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. He guides me along the right path. He is true to his name. If I should walk in the valley of darkness, no evil would I fear. You are there with your crook and your staff. With these you give me comfort. The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want. You have prepared a banquet for me in the sight of my foes. My head you have anointed with oil. My cup is overflowing. The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want. Surely goodness and kindness shall follow me all the days of my life. In the Lord's own house shall I dwell forever and ever. The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, if God is for us, who is against us? He who did not withhold his own son, but gave him up all for us, will he not with him also give us everything else? Who will bring any charge against God's elect? It is God who justifies. Who is to condemn? It is Christ Jesus who died, yes, who was raised, who is at the right hand of God, who indeed intercedes for us. Who will separate us from the love of Christ? Will hardships, or distress, or persecution, or famine, or nakedness, or peril, or sword? No, in all these things, we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. For I am convinced that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor rulers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. The word of the Lord. Please stand for the gospel. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. When Jesus arrived at Bethany, he found that Lazarus had already been in the tomb 4 days. Now Bethany was near Jerusalem, some 2 miles away. And many Jews had come to Martha and Mary to console them about their brother. When Martha heard that Jesus was coming, she went and met him, while Mary stayed at home. Martha said to Jesus, "Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died. But even now I know that God will give you whatever you ask of him." Jesus said to her, "Your brother will rise again." Martha said to him, "I know that he will rise again in the resurrection on the last day." Jesus said to her, "I am the resurrection and the life. Whoever believes in me, even though they die, will live. And everyone who lives and believes in me will never die. Do you believe this?" She said to him, "Yes, Lord, I believe that you are the Christ, the Son of God, the one coming into the world." The Gospel of the Lord. Please be seated. So my brothers and sisters, we are gathered here together in the presence of Almighty God to prayerfully honor the life of Maria Bitschek and to pray for her eternal salvation. Cherished wife of Jan and later Yosef, loving mother of Janina, Christina, Amelia, Richard, and the late Stefan, deeply adored by her many grandchildren and great-grandchildren. As we heard in today's first reading, for everything there is a season, a time for every matter under heaven, a time to be born. Maria was born on February 6, 1927, in Dubno, Poland, and she experienced many trials at a very young age. The oldest of six children, she was removed from her family by the Nazi regime, transported to Germany, and was a slave laborer for several years. After being liberated by American soldiers, she then spent several years in a displaced persons camp. Some people would likely give up under such difficult and trying circumstances, but not Maria. She courageously carried on. Today's first reading also says there is a time to die. And Maria's time for her earthly death was this past Tuesday, January the 19th. She was in her 94th year. And yet, as Catholics, we would say that January 19th, 2021, is also Maria's birthday, her ultimate birthday. For it is on this day that Maria entered into eternity, and we have this great hope that right now she is in the presence of God, worshiping Him along with all the saints. We have this great hope for Maria because there are many signs that her earthly life was one that responded to God's grace and in which the love of God for everyone poured out through her. For one, Maria was a great family woman, as everyone here knows this very well. In 1951, she and her family came to North America, first to New York, and then they later lived in various parts of Ontario, including right here in Simcoe for several decades. And during this time, she was fiercely devoted to her children and to other family members. After many years of searching, she reconnected with her Polish family who had been displaced by the Nazi regime, and then sponsored her siblings and their families to come to Canada. Maria was understandably devastated when her youngest son, Stefan, was killed in a car accident in the 1990s. But she did not get swallowed up by grief or discouragement. Once again, Maria demonstrated her great courage and determination and carried on by expressing her great love and commitment to her family. During the last few years of her earthly life, Maria lived at Norview Lodge, right here in Simcoe, and she maintained a close relationship with her family. And the fact that she was surrounded by loving family members when she passed away is yet another indicator of what an outstanding family woman Maria was. A definite survivor, Maria embraced the rugged lifestyle of Northern Ontario when she did live there, and she also worked at a hospital right here in Simcoe, using her energies and talents to serve the sick and the dying. A baptized Catholic, Maria practiced her faith at St. Cecilia's Catholic Church in nearby Port Dover. She also belonged to the Ladies' Circle of the Polish Alliance of Canada, both in Thunder Bay and in Delhi. Maria loved God's creation, and she expressed this in a particular way with her passion for gardening. A true matriarch who is described as the center of the family, Maria Rosalia Bitschek lived a courageously virtuous and productive life, who did so much to build up the kingdom of God. As I mentioned, Maria passed from this world on January 19th, 2021. And this date will be very meaningful for a long, long time. Let us also consider this year, 2021. 2,021 years. It's been about 2,021 years since Jesus of Nazareth walked on this earth, and he so enraged the authorities with his teachings and his actions that they executed him by nailing him to a cross. And if that's all there was to Jesus of Nazareth, this controversial figure who was crucified, then there's no way that our entire calendar system, our whole sense of time and order, would be based on his lifespan. But there is more to Jesus than this, much more, because shortly after his death, something magnificent happened. The unthinkable occurred, and Jesus Christ rose from the dead. He actually left his tomb and met with people. For St. Paul writes, Christ, who was raised on the third day in accordance with the scriptures, and he appeared to more than 500 of the brothers and sisters. Last of all, he appeared to me. Now, not surprisingly, this news about the resurrection of Jesus spread like wildfire, and it soon became clear to more and more people that Jesus Christ is indeed the Son of God, and it is through him that death is destroyed and eternal life is found. Lives were transformed, and many people died for their belief in Christ. And this continues today, his transformation of lives for Jesus Christ. And it's this belief in Christ, this truth in Jesus' death and resurrection, that gives us strength and hope when facing all of life's trials and challenges, including Maria's death. Let us listen again to those powerful words from our second reading. It is Christ Jesus who died, yes, who was raised. Who will separate us from the love of Christ? For I am convinced that neither death nor life nor anything else in all of creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. Indeed, nothing separates us from the love of Christ our Lord, the Good Shepherd, who leads us to calm waters and restores our souls. And during this challenging time, we need to fix our eyes on the Good Shepherd and to trust in his great love and mercy. For one thing I know is that he loves Maria more than we could ever imagine. And he loves all of us more than we could ever imagine. And being the Good Shepherd, Jesus Christ never stops in his efforts to bring us home to heaven so that we can experience what the church calls the beatific vision. It's described by St. John as being a state in which we shall be like God, for we shall see him as he is. Imagine that, to see God as he is, not through earthly eyes, but with a heavenly perspective that lasts for eternity. So let us never stop trusting in Jesus and in his infinite mercy and love, for as we hear today, he is the resurrection and the life, and whoever believes in him, even though they die, will live. It is in Jesus that we find rest for our souls. His yoke is easy, and his burden is light. This is because Jesus Christ is with us in every moment of our lives, even during challenging and difficult times like this. In today's funeral service, we pray for Maria. And our Catholic Christian faith tells us that life does not end at death. It only changes. And so it is crucial that we keep praying for Maria. And we take great comfort in the fact that in every Mass the Church will offer until the end of time, she will pray that Christ the Good Shepherd will bring Maria home to heaven. It has been only a few days since Maria has passed, and we likely came to this service with pain in our hearts, and we may leave this service with pain. And this pain will probably continue for a while, sometimes more intensely than others. But we are not lost in pain. Instead, we possess a pain that lends itself to hope. And ultimately, this hope is much greater than our pain. This is because it is a hope which recognizes that Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. And this Jesus Christ, who died and rose again, has the power to take away all our pains, all of our regrets, all of our sufferings, and to transform them for his glory in this life and in life everlasting. So let us reach out to God and pray to him, always remembering that I shall dwell in the house of the Lord my whole life long. Even though I walk through the darkest of valleys, I fear no evil, O Lord, for you are with me. Please stand. Brothers and sisters, Jesus Christ is risen from the dead, and he sits at the right hand of the Father, where he intercedes for his church. Confident that God hears the voices of those who trust in the Lord Jesus, we join our prayers to his. And there are a series of prayers here, and the response is, hear our prayer. In baptism, Maria received the light of Christ. Scatter the darkness now and lead Maria over the waters of death. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Our sister Maria was nourished at the table of the Savior. Welcome her into the halls of the heavenly banquet. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Many friends and members of our families have gone before us and await the kingdom. Grant them an everlasting home with your Son. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Many people die by violence, war, famine, sickness each day. Show your mercy to those who suffer unjustly these sins against your love and gather them to the eternal kingdom of peace. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Those who trusted in the Lord now sleep in the Lord. Give refreshment, rest, and peace to all those whose faith is known to you alone. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
The family and friends of Maria seek comfort and consolation. Heal their pain and dispel the darkness and doubt that comes from grief. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
We are assembled here in faith and confidence to pray for our sister Maria. Strengthen our hope so that we may live in the expectation of your Son's coming. Lord, in your mercy. Lord God, giver of peace and healer of souls, hear the prayers of the Redeemer, Jesus Christ, and the voices of your people, whose lives were purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ, and grant them a place in the kingdom through Christ our Lord. Amen. And now let us pray together the Lord's Prayer, the very words that our Savior Jesus Christ taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Before we take a pause, and we will be leaving to the cemetery, but before we're doing that, let us take leave of our sister Maria. May our farewell express our affection for her. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope that one day we shall joyfully greet Maria again, when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. In baptism, Maria shared in the death and resurrection of Christ. May Maria now be welcomed into the glory of eternal life. Father of mercies, we commend our sister Maria in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, Maria will rise with him on the last day. We give thanks for the blessings which you have bestowed upon Maria in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant, and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of death, to comfort one another with assurances of faith, until we all meet in Christ and are with you and our sister Maria once again. My friends, may every mark of affection and every gesture of friendship that you give to others be a sign of God's peace for you. So at this point, there's going to be a video tribute to Maria, and then from there, we will be proceeding in peace, processing to the cemetery for the burial ceremony.
God. into your eyes. And when I talk to you, it just echoes in my mind. But if hearts are made of dust, and if we fell from the stars, I'd look up tonight and know just where you are. That you're
face the devil. You were no stranger.